And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. The Tigers have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week, and as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made at the 31. So they go to the air and pick up six.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down right around the 48-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. So the scramble goes for 9 yards. There he goes. And they get nice yardage on that run.
I think you got to give credit to the big boys up front there. They're able to get this back to room that he needed.
Quick pass. They'll bring him down at the 21. First down.
Blue 80.
And they hit him in the backfield. A 1 yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 22-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled just outside the goal line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
Touchdown, Tigers. He makes the PAT. A nice 8-play, 74-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. The pitch, and he's got some room. Brought down at the 46-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
Good outside run there. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
Mike 12,
the stop right around the 44-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. Nice run there. A nice 7-yard gain on the option keeper.
Third down.
It up the middle for a nice run. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
That'll bring up second and 12.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 35-yard line. He gets to about the 27-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. He's going to try and scramble, and he hits him hard at the 32.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
First down.
Clemson holds a 4-point lead. Gets hit out of bounds around the 45-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
And he's taken down at the 42-yard line. Slings it. He's hit and taken down.
That makes it first and 10.
And he's tackled at the 22-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. So at the end of one, Clemson leads it 7-3. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. The strike complete. It's on a move. Touchdown.
give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead. And on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Tackle at the 22.
This is a big-time read by this safety. You know, a lot of times as a safety, you're sitting back there making sure there isn't a play-action pass or a play potentially that can go behind you. I think this safety has that sixth sense. His instincts on that play were special. He read the run, got into the backfield, and made the play.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Third and nine. Ball on their own 26. Under heavy pressure. He goes out of bounds at the 29.
That'll make it fourth and six.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 39. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Bounces off the would-be tackler.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. Quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
And a quick throw.
That's a deep seven on the play. That makes it third and three.
He's at the 40. Makes it to the 37.
That's a gain of 17 on the play. First down.
Easy.
First down grab by the receiver, and he's tackled in the open field.
First down.
Touchdown, Clemson! Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he hits the PAT. A six-play, 61-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 21-3. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And down he goes at the 27-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 27-yard line, second down.
Watch his flat. Watch his flat. Mike 12. Mike 12.
at the 30-yard line.
That's a gain of three on the play. Third down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. Hand off, and he's met in the backfield. His way to midfield, and the fullback comes up with a nice run.
This is just strength on strength right here. They give it to the fullback, and he powers his way for some good yardage and another first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 50. He's got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 46.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
Now he's scrambling.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Now he's going to run, and watch out. Good tackle there in space. We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
It's our time. Mike 12. Mike 12.
Throws complete, and he's got space to work. The Yellow Jackets use their second timeout. So the completion goes for about 5 yards and a first down.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's taken down at the 11.
Boy, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
And he throws it away. And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Larry, Larry, Larry! Mike 12, Mike 12!
Hey, Titan.
He takes it right side for a good game.
Game of 6 yards. That'll bring up 34.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Quick thinking there. You know, they're liable to put the ball in the air on third, so it's a smart play to keep your hands ready.
Fourth down. This one should be makeable. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Georgia Tech is lining up to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. The Tigers right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back at the first half, you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack. And in my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked.
Check four, check four.
Quick strike, and he drops it. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Tigers in front by 15.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. innovation that excites. David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 26-yard line.
Mike 12. Mike 12.
Set. He fights forward to about the 26. Throws left. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid fundamental pass defense.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And down he goes at the 38. We're about set to start things up again. Receivers got the first down. They'll bring him down at the 47.
Number 11 makes the tackle at the 47-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
They get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it second and six.
And they make the stop at the 42. Around the 30-yard line. Looks to him again. Complete.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
Brought down at the 29-yard line.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. Steps out of bounds around the 28-yard line. Kick is up, and he got it. the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Clemson's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets out to around the 35. First and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. They bring him down in the backfield.
A good tackling safety is key for any defense. And if they can diagnose a play like this guy can, he can be a real menace.
He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 35. And he's taken down around the 42-yard line. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Gives it to the back. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it 7-6.
And he's tackled right around the 24-yard line.
No gain on the way. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
And he tackles him hard at the 36.
Number 32 on the tackle at the 36-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
He scrambles. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Gets out to around the 48.
Gain of 10 on the play. 1st down.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. So they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
2nd down and 11. Ball on the 47. This is the 9th play of this drive. Tackle around the 39-yard line.
That makes it 3rd and 7.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He gets hit out of bounds at the 16. So with 1 quarter remaining, the Tigers in front, 24-6. into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
And down he goes at the 2-yard line.
That's a deep three-yard play. That brings up second and goal.
Touchdown, Tigers. He makes the PAT. A long 15-play, 81-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. They bring him down.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack.
Toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Going deep. And he's immediately tackled. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. He's scrambling. Looking for the corner. Tackle made around the 12-yard line. And he has a huge gain.
And I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
Knock him down for a loss. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
Let's go, D.
From the 15-yard line, second down.
Down. 10.
He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. He's taken down at the 5.
That's good for D.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's going to come up short. Good tackle.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run, and when the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. And so now the ball's turned over on downs.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
That's a great tackle at the 5-yard line. Loss of 2 on the run by the halfback.
I'm sure this running back will be looking around for that guy the next time he takes a handoff.
It's second down. Tough spot here deep in their own territory. It to the 14. Third down. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's tackled around the 24-yard line.
Number 35 with the tackle.
From their own 24-yard line. First down. Under a minute left. Here's the give. Tackled after decent pickup.
That'll bring up second and 3.
And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 31-6, Clemson. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
Well, you had a feeling that this one might not be close. You can't fault these guys for not giving it their best. They were just out of their league today. Clemson simply dismantled these guys, and I don't think anybody was figuring on anything less.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.